The Bible says that a woman's hair is her glory, and of course it is a crown that you cannot take off her head. And for Muhanguzi Grace, this is what he finds passion in, making women, look beautiful and great. Join me today on Legit Hustlers as we get into his world of how he started and where he is today. My name is Brenda Kembabas. So in a nutshell, who is Muhanguzi Grace?
I'm a hairdresser, I do hairdressing. Muhanguzi Grace is a father, he's a married guy. Okay, I actually went to school to study hairdressing, but I realized most of the things I was taught in school are quite different from what I do, because I'm naturally an artist. It comes with an art when I'm doing things. It's quite different from what I even learned from school.
How long have you done this? Take us a little back, like from the time you finished school to getting into hairdressing.
I used to be in school, and in my halls, I used to part-time at a friend's salon, like at the village, you get. But in my mind, I never knew I would do hairdressing. I thought I would be an engineer. My parents wanted me to be like a doctor, an engineer.
What did you do at the university?
I did Bachelor of Business Administration. That's what I did. But then after, I found that I have a lot of passion. Like, I used to try singing meanwhile. Like, the guys that I went to school with, they knew me as a person who's going to be an artist and stuff like that.
Explains the dream.
Yeah, exactly. So I realized there's a lot of hustle in music. And then I realized I'm not the type of being an engineer, a doctor. I wasn't that kind. So the only thing to resort to was as if hairdressing, because I already had an idea. I knew saloon society, because I'd been there before. I started slowly like that. I went into different saloons. I tried stuff here and there. And then it reached a point when I was growing up and I realized I had to probably put it on a level where it makes me earn a living.
So as a business administrator into hairdressing, so did you choose to put aside your books and do what you loved, or rather it was something you did because you maybe failed to get a job through your course?
I did not fail to get a job. I just felt like I did not belong to the world of
business administration.
Yeah, I did not belong there, much as I did it, because I was wise, like I had the knowledge for the books, but then I realized the passion. As I did that because at my HSC I did PEM art. So there was something to do with books and art. When you're wise enough, you choose where you think you're more comfortable, you could earn more. Because I'm not sure, but I doubt I would be earning as much as I do earn if I was in business and stuff like that.
So can you take us back on when you actually started your own salon?
I actually started my own salon in this same place. Right now, we are in two rooms. We have just expanded. We are trying to just expand according to the clients flowing. We realize that we need space. So, and we are willing to create more and more space depending on the clients that come in. When we started, we did not have plans of we will expand. We were just working, and we felt comfortable, and we had enough of the clients that we had then. But we realized that there are a lot of people that need jobs. People have passion. Now, like right now, we have an academy to train guys, hairdressing and stuff. But we believe that among the many that we train, we could get a class of people that could be as serious as we are.
So starting a salon, you loved hairdressing. How were you able to get people who had the same passion or probably the same skill in hairdressing?
People out there, they think this guy is really earning a lot of money. So they come with this urge of, if I ever did what he does, I could earn. So out of those few that come in, you find that there is actually one that really, really has the passion, and they're not even about the money. Because actually, me, when I was learning hair, it wasn't about the money. I was learning something that I loved. It is the clients that later on realized that there is a grace somewhere, and they started coming to me.
So you were telling us about the name Luke.
Luke Grace. Luke G. So it is the whole point of a name, Luke G. It is meant to, I like it when you come out of here and they can easily tell you're coming from Grace. So it is Luke G. Yeah. You get the point?
Yes, I get it.
Exactly.
You look like you're from Grace.
Exactly. So Luke G. You Luke G.
So how did you start with Luke G in the first place? Before people could actually look at someone and tell that they were from here.
Yes, I started small, but because of probably what we do, the things we offer, the people have really appreciated what we do, it grows automatically. You just see people coming in, and you know that you have to expand, like I told you. You get my point? It just grows automatically. As long as you're doing something good, people will come. And now when they come, you realize that you have little space. So you create more space.
So if someone watching you out there is thinking, I want to become a hairdresser and maybe become like Grace one day, what advice do you have for them, especially in small beginnings?
In the first place, you have to know that you really love what you're about to do. Like, not for the money. You first have to love what you're going to do. Like, do you really love it? Do you have that passion? Because as long as you love it, trust me, what you're doing will do itself. It will automatically come out. And then, the money will come. What I don't advise people to do is people who see someone successful in business and they say, okay, someone did this and they were successful. Let me go out there and start a salon. You'll be disappointed. Make sure you love it. Get. And then, the money comes later, and it surely does come as long as you're doing a good job.
So tell us about the challenges while you were trying to grow this brand of Luke G.
Now, number one, I have a lot of socialites and celebrities I work on, and they are friends with me. But it is quite challenging that they have not really been easy for me. They are good influencers, but they have not been easy for me to help me grow. I realized that I have to find my own ways of trying to, you know. So I stopped looking at now the influencers, and I just said, let me randomly just land on someone, and by God's grace, probably, someone will help out. But I've really, really tried to talk to people, those that even have the platforms to help you, actually. I've told them, let's work together. Later on we would achieve from this, both of us. I told them how we can do it. They are either busy or they are not willing, or I just don't know up to now.
So as a man, how have you managed to grow in a business that many people look at as a business for women?
Yeah, because the thing is, you know, in every business, there are both things that are quite woman and things that are really quite man. Now, when it comes to aggressive work, I prefer that a man has to be in that system. Though there are women that actually do the things that men should have done. Because me, when I'm on YouTube, I see women cutting men's hair, and they are really, really good. Something I've not so much seen around here. So, and most of the things I do myself are the ones that you need to be aggressive. The man work in the salon. There are things I do. Because sometimes on a busy day, I stand from morning till like midnight. I just take a break to probably breakfast and lunch. I don't see a lot of women, you know, into stuff like that.
Currently, what people plate today is not what they were plating 5 years ago. So how do you manage to keep on trend with what is on?
Like I told you, me, I'm an artist, like naturally. Whatever trends, there are things that trend and I've done them like way back. I just created it on someone's head and I see it trending now. So I believe I can roll with anything as long as it is hair, it is crafty with hands. So that is how I manage. It comes easy.
So what are those key characteristics you look at in people when you're choosing them to become your employees, especially the ones that I see around here?
When I'm choosing someone to be my employee, they are interviewed. Because people come, I've had an experience where people come and tell me they want to work with me when they actually want to learn what I'm doing. So with that, right now when someone comes and they want to work with me, they tell me I do this, I do that, I do that, I do that. I interview them and they at least have to have 70% of what I require.